Hi guys, so now we will be solving a material balance in a single unit. We have here a diagram, and what we are required is to find out how many kilograms of each component will be there in each stream. So, ang kailangan nating malaman is kung gaano karaming component A ang nandito sa ating stream na M1, ilan ang component B, sa M2 ganun din, gaano karami ang B and C, sa M3, sa M4, gano'ng karami yung A, B, C, at sa M5, gano'ng karami yung B and C. So, everything will be expressed in terms of kilogram as per our requirement dito sa ating question, no? Okay, so let us start by doing a overall material balance. Okay, so meron tayong dalawang stream na pumapasok at meron tayong tatlong stream na lumalabas. So, our overall material balance will be M1 plus M2 is equal to yung mga lumalabas natin, which is M3 plus M4 plus M5. And as you can see sa ating diagram, given ang values natin ng M1, ng M2, and then ang ating M4. So, given ang mga values nila, so let us substitute that dito sa ating overall material balance. So, our M1 is equal to 3,000 plus our M2, which is 2,500, is equal to M3 plus M4 is equal to 1,200 plus M5. So, 3,000 plus 2,500 minus 1,200 is equal to 4,300. So, we have here 4,300 is equal to M3 plus M5. So, this will be our equation 1. And then, magko-component balance tayo, no? So, ano yung nakikita nating pinakamadali dito? Well, I think ang pinakamadaling makuha is itong component A. Because as you can see, dito sa ating M1 stream, given na kagad yung value ng ating M1. So, we can take the 70% of that and that will be our component A. And then, walang component A dito sa M2. Ang M3 naman natin is pure component A. And then, ang M4, meron ding component A dito but given din yung value ng M4. So, we can also take the percentage of this and that will be our component A, no? So, let us do a component A balance. Okay, so in M1, we have 70% of 3,000. So, we have here 0.7 times 3,000. Okay, then walang component A dito sa M2. So, this will be equal to M3, which is 100%. So, we'll have here M3 plus in our M4, we have 20% of 1,200. So, we have here 0.2 times 1,200. Okay, so we can solve for M3 using this equation. No? So, we will have here M3 is equal to, so we will have here 0.7 times 3,000. Minus 0.2 times 1,200. So, our M3 will be equal to 1,860 kilogram. So, immediately guys, this value will be the value of component A dito sa M3 because this is consist of 100% component A. Okay? So, our M3 is equal to 1,860 kilogram. Which is pure component A. So, our component A is equal to 1,860 kilogram. Okay? So, now going back dito sa ating overall material balance, alam na natin ngayon yung value ng M3. Therefore, makukuha na natin yung value ng M5. So, that means we have here M5 is equal to 4,300 minus M3, which is 1,860. So, our M5 is equal to 2,440 kilogram. Okay, so now we know the value of M5. This is equal to 2,440 kilogram. Bago tayo magpatuloy sa ating discussion, we would like to ask for your support by subscribing sa ating YouTube channel. Please click on the notification bell para lagi kayong updated sa mga videos na ipopost namin. Now, before going any further, let us get the value of each component dito sa mga given na natin. Ano? Madali nang makuha yan. So, component A is equal to 70% of 3,000. So, this is equal to 2,100 kilogram. And then, component B is consists of the remaining 30%. So, we have 30% of 3,000, which is equal to 900 kilogram. So, that is why you can see here 2,100 plus 900 is equal to 3,000. Now, for M2, 40% of 2,500 is equal to 0.4 times 2,500. And this is equal to 1,000. So, we have the rest of the material in M2 is component C. So, that means we have 1,500 kilogram because we have 1,000 kilogram of component B. So, we have here 1,500 kilogram of component C. Okay? And now, from here, we can also get the values, no? So, component A is 20% of 1,200, which is equal to 240 kilogram. And for component B, 70% of 1,200, which is equal to 840 kilogram. Now, the rest is component C. So, that is 10% of M4. So, 10% of 1,200 is equal to 120 kilogram. Okay? So, if you add all this, you will have 1,200 kilogram. And now, ang hindi na lang natin alam is itong component B and component C dito sa M5, no? So, wala pa tayong value kung gaano karami yan. So, we have to do another component balance, no? We can either do component B balance or component C balance para makuha natin yung ating amount of material na nasa M5. So, I will do component B balance. Okay, so we have component B dito sa ating M1, no, which is equal to 900 kilogram. So, I'll have here 900 plus component B sa ating M2, which is equal to 1,000 kilogram. And this is equal to, there is no component B in M3. We have component B dito sa ating M4, which is equal to 840 kilogram. Plus, our component B dito sa M5. So, we don't know how much is our component B here. So, we'll have here component B in our M5. Okay? So, therefore, our component B sa ating M5 is equal to 1,900 minus 840. So, our B in M5 is equal to 1,060 kilogram. Okay, so now we know the value of our component B. We have here 1,060 kilogram. So how much component C we have in our M5? Okay, so our component C in our M5 is equal to 2,400, our M5, 2,440 minus our component B, which is 1,060 kilogram. So, our component C in M5 is equal to 1,380 kilogram. So now we have a value of our component C. In our M5, we have 1,380 kilogram. And this will be our final answer for this problem. Well, that's it for now, guys, and thank you for watching. We are inviting you to register sa www.enginerds.org. It is a community of Filipino engineers, engineering students, and STEM students. Thank you very much and have a nice day!